Hi, my name is Alex and I'm a senior associate at Ingentium Limited, an intellectual property and intelligence consultancy which is based in Edinburgh, Scotland. Ingentium has, in collaboration with IHSMarkit, a global provider of intelligence products and publisher of AnimalPharm, prepared a thorough report on African Swine Fever, or ASF. The report covers ASF's impact across the world and current progress towards developing an ASF vaccine. In this vlog, I will discuss the key findings of the report and emphasize why, if you had any doubts, ASF is the most important animal disease of our time. African Swine Fever, or ASF, is a highly contagious viral disease which affects domestic and wild pigs. Once infected, pigs will suffer from internal hemorrhaging and will ultimately die within 10 days. There is currently no vaccine or treatment for the disease yet, which is rapidly spreading, disrupting basic protein availability, consumption patterns, and the international meat trade. However, this provides a blockbuster opportunity for those involved in understanding the science of the disease and in developing interventions to combat its spread. ASF is endemic in many African countries, to which it was limited to until 2007 when the ASF virus entered the country of Georgia. As of the beginning of 2020, the presence of ASF has been confirmed in Poland, Romania, and throughout much of Eastern and Central Europe. The ASF virus reached China in August 2018, from where it has since gone on to spread to the Philippines, Vietnam, and throughout the rest of Southeast Asia. The ASF virus affects all members of the pig family, which includes domesticated swine, European wild boars, warthogs, bush pigs, and giant forest hogs. ASF does not currently pose a threat to human health, as the ASF virus cannot be transmitted to humans. ASF can be transmitted directly, indirectly, or can be vector-borne and transmitted through ticks. Infected swine will develop a high viral load, which can easily shed and lead to further direct or indirect transmission through fomites on contaminated clothing, shoes, equipment, or vehicles. Wild boar has played an important role in spreading the disease. However, larger geographical leaps are considered to be a result of human activity and the international transportation of domestic pigs. For example, the first ASF outbreak outside of Africa was reported in 1957 in Portugal, where it is presumed to have been caused by pigs feeding from food waste containing pork from Angola near Lisbon Airport. As previously mentioned, there's no vaccine for ASF, although in China, false products claiming to be ASF vaccines have been marketed to farmers. Implementation of ASF control methods varies amongst countries depending on the epidemiological status of the disease, that is, whether or not it's endemic, and also the type of pig production, that is, traditional backyard or commercial. Biosecurity measures to prevent the entrance of ASF onto a farm include fences, restriction of visitors and vehicles, use of dedicated clothes and footwear, safe disposal of carcasses, avoiding the use of potential contaminated feed, including squeal, and introducing new animals via quarantine and from well-known sources. In fact, the Czech Republic demonstrated in 2017, after ASF was detected in two wild boar, how biosecurity measures can eliminate ASF. The country took several measures, which included increased passive surveillance, a ban on hunting and wild boar feeding, and enclosing the risk area with order and electric fences to ensure that the disease would remain contained and not spread any further throughout the country or region. The last confirmed case of ASF in the Czech Republic was in February 2018. Broadly speaking, the presence of ASF has led to a dramatic decrease in pig populations, leading to shortened supplies of pork, breeding stock, and in some cases, significant price increases. This is most notable in China, where the price of pork has increased significantly and where the share prices of breeding companies also increased due to high demand for pork. China, the USA, Germany, Spain, and Brazil are the world's top pig producers, producing over 60% of the world's pigs. Pig production in these countries is made up of specialized medium to large intensive commercial farms, except for China, which we'll move on to shortly. In contrast, there are traditional or backyard operations which are more susceptible to ASF due to low implementation of adequate biosecurity measures and the use of swill feed, which remains an important mode of transmission of the disease. It is worth noting that countries in which ASF is endemic are primarily reliant on backyard operations. China has lost an estimated 50% of its pig population in the first reported case of ASF in 2018. Unlike the other top producing nations, China has a large share of backyard operations. It is reported that 85% of the herd population loss has occurred among small-scale and backyard producers. The losses have led to unprecedented shortages in the country's pork supply, which has altered global trade flows and will continue to do so for the foreseeable future. In order to cater for the increasing demand in the wake of production loss, global exports of pork are predicted to increase by 10%, a record high. Nonetheless, it is believed that even through the increase of imports, China will struggle to make up for its reduced production capacity due to ASF. Vaccination is, in principle, the most effective way of controlling animal viral diseases through preventing mortality or reducing morbidity. Live attenuated vaccines for ASF were used in the 1960s in Spain and Portugal, but they led to the appearance of chronic forms of ASF. All other approaches, including inactivated viruses, recombinant proteins, and DNA vaccines, have not yielded as yet an effective and safe ASF vaccine. As a result of this, we have seen a global increase in the number of ASF-related technologies being patented in the last 10 years. Based on this trend, it is expected that patent filings and R&D funding will continue to grow over the next few years. A mixture of both public and private sector organizations appear as applicants or owners of ASF-related patents. Some notable applicants include the University of Yangzhou in China, which has been carrying out research on ASF as early as the mid-2000s and filed its latest ASF-related patent in 2019. In the USA, the US Department of Agriculture has patent filings which claim ASF vaccine technologies with a focus on the ASF virus Georgia 2007 isolate. And finally, in Europe, we have Boehringer Ingelheim, which also appears as a top applicant. Some of these organizations have or are in the process of commercializing their vaccine technologies. There are also other forms of interventions being developed, including genetically modified pigs which are resistant to ASF. Buyers of this report also gain access to a detailed list of patents and patent applications related to ASF globally. The European Commission estimates a timeline of around 8 years, with the probability of success varying between 50 to 80%. In the short term, the live attenuated vaccines are the most promising candidates, but further research is needed to confirm their safety and efficacy in long-term controlled experiments. Given the spread of ASF across various farming systems and geographies, it is important to consider what a target product profile should look like for an ASF vaccine. Our report suggests what a minimal and ideal target product profile would look like for an ASF vaccine. Our report also provides further insights on the impact of ASF on international trade and ancillary industries, as well as socioeconomics. Lastly, we have estimated the potential value of an ASF vaccine for the Asian market, where ASF is currently ravaging domestic production. This comprehensive report is available for purchase through IHSMarkit. For more information, contact them at agrimarketing@IHSMarkit or use the links below to access the full table of contents and sample pages from the report. I hope you enjoyed watching our vlog, and as always, feel free to get in touch with us at info@ingentium.co.uk. Until next time.